My name is Leo Dess, CEO of Group 337 and The Inside, and along with our friends at Alcatraz AI, we've kicked off a mini-series titled The Next Generation of Access Control. The purpose of this is to spark a conversation and a change, and a start of a new language for the industry. If we agree that the access control industry has entered its next generation, we should agree we need to look, say, and act next generation. In part one, we dove into the difference between the old facial recognition and the new facial authentication. This week, we dive into biometrics. Next month, we tackle how we interact with the built environment and buildings, structures, and that we come and go. So, all right, let's get into biometrics. Let's use a sports analogy to explain how I, and I know many of you, feel about biometrics. In any sport, there's always a team that shows all the promise in the world. Everyone wants them to win. Once in a while, they even actually do it. They score that last minute goal and it gives us all a bunch of hope. But time after time, they just frankly disappoint. Just like historical biometrics. I mean, the concept and idea, they're great. No cards, no fobs. Just walk right up. Use my finger, maybe even my eye or a heartbeat, and I just walk right in. But let's be real, it hasn't panned out like we all have thought it would. But I wouldn't blame it all on biometrics. I'd blame it on timing, technology, and the applications that we've used it. We had hand geometry biometrics, big and clunky, that took a picture of the top of your hand. Fingerprint readers that needed touch. But what happened when you had gloves on or a Band-Aid? Then we had gait that used how we walked, but it was hard to enroll. Then came Iris, the gold standard, but hard to implement, and it relied on a habitual user to know how to do it correctly, and on and on and on, without ever really taking off. But that's okay. Times have changed. We're in the midst of a turning point. The biometrics of yesterday are not going to determine the biometrics of today. I think they will play an even more significant part in the next generation of access control. It just will look a little different. And because of that difference, we need to start using that different language. We need to start acting differently, and we have to have different expectations. But before we go into the future, let's take a quick trip back to the past. We want to understand how we got to today so that we can give us a little bit of insight into how it may play out very soon into the future. To go back to the beginning, we need to go back to 1853 to Paris, France, and meet Alfonso Bertillon. Alfonso was a French police officer and a biometrics researcher who applied this study to law enforcement. He created an identification system based on physical measurements. This was the first scientific system used by police to identify criminals. Pretty cool stuff. But before that time, criminals could only be identified by a name or a photograph. The method was eventually supplanted by Edward Henry. Edward Henry created the fingerprint standard called the Henry Classification System. In between those two was a gentleman by the name of Juan Vucetic from Argentina, who in 1881 started a collection of fingerprints of criminals in Argentina. But the Henry Classification System was pretty much the watershed moment of all innovation around biometrics. The 60s brought us, thanks to the FBI, automation to capture and extract biometric data. The 80s put a focus on speech and speech recognition. Siri and Alexa and many more can thank NIST for that. Then the 1990s brought us eyes and the first iris recognition algorithm that blood vessel patterns in the eyes were unique. It also brought us facial detection technology. The technology was used for real-time recognition. Which brings us to the 2000s and an explosion in biometric algorithms being developed. And we saw new use cases outside of just high security. It's pretty cool. Biometrics is rooted in identity and verification. They're rooted in high security. It has never really been about convenience. Sure, the concept was there, but in reality, it was about the high level of assurance and comfort or convenience was never a priority. And this is where the rub of yesterday's biometrics meets today. Until recently, we have been applying, in general, those 1960s technology of crime fighting with assurance to 2000s in the use cases of convenience and assurance. We have not unlocked what is needed for the next generation to happen. So what is next generation? I believe it is two things. It's touchless and it's frictionless. For mass adoption and the value to happen, we need to focus on both of those. And the old won't, but the new, it will. Here are three examples of many of how the next generation of biometrics and access control will work and it will look. The first one is pattern matching versus the neural networks. The face as a biometric delivers on the three critical attributes for successful adoption of next generation access control and biometrics. You have security, touchless, and frictionless. In old biometrics were done using pattern matching, just like fingerprints. And like fingerprints, old facial biometrics used pattern matching to authenticate the user. These widely adopted solutions uses a unique individual identifier, but Forbes reported that hackers claim to have found a way to beat any fingerprint scanner in 20 minutes. In the next generation of access control, biometrics use multi-sensor technology, allowing it to accurately identify individuals from a distance and determine if they have clearance to enter a secure area or not. Facial biometrics of today and tomorrow are using neural networks with more parameters such as the height of the nose, the distance between the eyes, and many more to match, making it tougher to hack. The second is how processing gets done. In the old way, you use servers versus the new and the next generation of access control and biometrics, where you do it at the edge. The benefits of computing at the edge are speed, latency, and security. And lastly, a third differentiation between the old and the new focuses on what you were solving for. In the old access control with biometrics, it was just an alternative to a badge reader, giving someone the ability to unlock a door and gain entrance. The new and the next generation of access control in biometrics is about solving the enterprise door use cases and value beyond the lock, such as tailgating, the knowns versus unknowns, people counting, levels of awareness, and notifications. It is not just about locking and unlocking anymore. Yes, that is 100% part of the value creation story. Still, in the next generation of access control and biometrics, it is about going beyond that. It's about going beyond that value and doing it where you can deliver safety, convenience, and wellness. And through technology and innovation, not only iteration, is the way we get to the next generation of access control. Next month, we will tackle you in the way we interact with spaces. Till next time, thank you for taking the time to join me, The Inside, and Alcatraz AI as we work together to bring the future to today and redefine access control for tomorrow.